Today I want to talk about habit creation and some of the myths or misconceptions, at least that I've noticed, and I bet that you've noticed some of these things too. Now, for anybody that's into the self-development stuff, you've probably seen a lesson or read a book about how habits get formed in something like 26 to 30 days. Then if you keep doing that habit or doing that action over and over, up to 90 days, it kind of becomes like an ingrained habit, something you do automatically without thinking, kind of like the act of breathing or reacting to a loud noise that just comes naturally ingrained in our brain. And I've noticed that this doesn't always work for other habits, success habits, so to speak, in our life. And so I want to shed some light on that and what I found. So the idea of doing something for 90 days to the point where it becomes automatic, if it's something that you don't do naturally, like breathing or eating or drinking or being afraid when something's coming at you, those kind of things, then I don't think 90 days really cuts it. I think the idea of a habit is something that you commit to forever, basically. And habits really should be adopted slowly and deliberately, but not really too many at once. And don't shoot for this whole 90-day, if I only do it for 90 days, then I'm going to be an expert at this thing. Well, yeah, if you do something for 90 days, you'll be an expert at it, but on day 91, you still have to go and do that thing. And I want to talk about an experiment that I tried. It was about a year and a half ago. I did a 90-day challenge. I was all jacked up on this book I read about habit creation. I said, okay, I'm going to do a 90-day fitness challenge. And for these 90 days, I'm not going to touch a drop of alcohol. I'm going to work out every single day. Didn't mean I was going to lift weights every day, but I'd do something active every single day. And that wasn't too far of a stretch for me because I was already working out probably 3 or 4 days a week. So I was just bumping the number up. But still, to work out 90 straight days is a pretty big shock to the system if you haven't done that before. And by the end of the 90-day trial, obviously it was in great shape. I was feeling good. I'd dropped some weight. It was looking good. Hadn't touched any alcohol. That's obviously very good for your system. But on day 91, it was like the whole time I was just waiting for this thing to end so that I could go out and have a few drinks and eat what I wanted and not work out. And so that habit didn't necessarily ingrain itself. Now, I still work out quite frequently, but I don't do it every single day. And as well, I still like to partake in an alcoholic beverage. So it doesn't mean that I created this new habit of not drinking anymore. So ultimately what I found out in this experiment is that that's a habit. Being healthy and being fit is a habit I wanted to create. And I just had to commit to doing that for the rest of my life. And I still work out very regularly, and it's something I've ingrained into my life. I don't do it every single day, but I still have to tell myself and schedule it that this is something I'm going to do. I need to go to the gym, or I need to go for a run. I need to book it into my week, and I'm a really busy person. I fill up probably 18 to 20 hours every single day doing stuff. And so workouts have to be something that I schedule and go and do. It's not like suddenly my subconscious mind kicks in, says, go get your keys and drive to the gym. I have to plan it. I have to actively do it. And so habit creation really happens that way. It's more of a commitment to a lifestyle change and a lifestyle setting that you want to have. So if it's a success habit, let's say, even if it's blogging, a lot of people watching this are bloggers. Well, if you want to commit to doing a blog, then don't just commit to doing 30 posts for the next 30 days and trust that you're going to be a full-time blogger at that point. Commit to being a full-time blogger and give it 2 years and see where that goes. But maybe you don't have to blog every single day. Maybe you just have to come up with one powerful post per week and then use accountability systems to make sure that you keep doing that. The habits that really form, that create success in your life are ones that you just commit to doing over a long period of time. So that's sort of my discussion around the myth of habit creation. I'm curious to see what you found, because I know that some people are really stuck on, if I just do something for 90 days, it's going to be automatic. I haven't found that so much myself. I still have to take action after the 90 days, after 300 days, after 1,000 days. You still have to go out and take that action unless it's something that happens totally biologically in your system. So let me know what you think, and I look forward to speaking to you again soon.